السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So we'll continue on from the book one of Durus al-Lughat al-Arabiya. So we are actually going to start the chapter five, but before that, we have done the chapter four. We didn't do the grammar for lesson 4A. So we'll continue on with that, inshallah. So lesson 4A, the grammar. In this part, we learn two more prepositions, min meaning from and ila meaning to. We also learn two more pronouns, ana meaning I, anta, which means you. So ana, I is for both masculine and feminine. For example, ana Muhammadun, I am Muhammad. Ana Aminatu, I am Amina. But anta, you, is only for masculine singular. You will learn the feminine and plural forms later on. You also learn here two verbs, dhahaba, he went, and kharaja, he went out. For example, note the following. Where is Bilal? Aina Bilalun? He went to the mosque. Dhahaba ilal masjidi. He went to the mosque. Bilal went to the mosque. Dhahaba Bilalun ilal masjidi. So dhahaba means he went. But if it is followed by a noun as a subject, the pronoun he is dropped. So for example, so if it's followed by a noun, Bilal, the pronoun he is dropped. Vocabulary, min is from. If it is followed by al, it becomes mina. Ila is to. Al Filipino is the Philippines. Al Yabano is Japan. Al Madrasatu, school. Asinu, China. Asuku, market. Al Hindu, India. Al Jamiatu, university. Al Mudiru, headmaster. So now we'll go on to the lesson 5 of the grammar book. And then we'll continue on with the lesson of lesson 5 from the book. In this lesson, we'll learn the following. Bilal's book. It's Kitabu Bilalin. And then the Imam's house. Baitul Imami. So if you see here, the first word, Kitabu Bilalin. The first word is a thing possessed. It is called Mudaf. Then the second word, Bilal, Bilalin, is the possessor. It is called Mudafilin. Note that the Mudaf takes neither the definite nor the indefinite article. So it is wrong to say Kitabun Bilalin or Al Kitabu Bilalin. The Mudaf is definite by position and does not need the definite article. Whereas the mudaf ilayh is in the genitive case. It can have a tanween, for example, here Bilalin, as in the first example, or the al, as in the second example. Bilalin, Bilalun becomes Baitu Bilalin. So if it is mudaf ilayh, it becomes Bilalin. Al imamu, if it has al, so it will become imami. So Baitul imami. Kitabu man, whose book? Note that the man is not in the genitive case. Yeah, so even though it is mudafila, it's not in the genitive case because it is indeclinable. That is, it does not change to indicate its function. There are certain indeclinable nouns in Arabic which remain unchanged. Ala maktabil mudarrisi. So note that maktab is in genitive case because of the preposition harfajar ala. And mudarris, mudarrisi, is in the genitive case because it is mudafil. Tahta means under. The noun following under is also genitive because it is also mudafilai. For example, tahtal maktabi, under the table. Tahtal kitabi, under the book. Ya is a vocative particle. A noun following the ya, it has only one dhamma. For example, Ya Bilalun, so it's Ya Bilalu, and it's not Ya Bilalu. Same thing. Ya Shaykhu, it's not Ya Shaykhun. Oh Bilal, oh Mr., oh Sir. Ya Ustadu, oh Teacher, it's not Ya Ustadu. The words Ismun and Ibnun commence with Hamzatul Wasl. So when preceded by the word, the E is dropped in a pronunciation. For example, if you see here, Ismul Waladi Bilalun. The boy's name is Bilal. So if you put wa, so then it's Hamzatul Wasl. So then it, the E is, you don't pronounce E. So you say, Wasmul Binti Aminatu. Wasmul Waladi Bilalun. So you remove the, you don't pronounce the E. So Wasmul Binti Aminatu. And the girl's name is Amina. Ibnul Mudarrisi Tabibun. The teacher's son is a doctor. And so instead of, you don't say wa ibnu, here you say wabnu. Wabnul imami tajirun. And the imam's son is merchant. So we use imami because of its mudafilay. Vocabulary. Ar-Rasulu, the messenger. Tahta is under or beneath. Al-Ammu is paternal uncle. Al-Ibnu, son. Ash-Shariu, street. As-Sayyaratu is car. Al-Kaabatu is Kaaba. Huna is here. Al-Khalu is maternal uncle. Hunaka is there. Mughlaqun is closed or shut. Al-Bintu is daughter. Al-Ismu is the name. Al-Tabibu, doctor. Al-Haqibatu is bag or a case. Let us go to the book and start the fifth lesson. Ad-Darsu al-Khamis, fifth lesson. Sa'id is saying, A-Kitabu Muhammadin, because it's Mudafilay, then there's no al, that's why you use Muhammadin. A-Kitabu Muhammadin, Hadha Ya Yasiru. Is this book, is this Muhammad's book or Yasir's? Yasir is replying, La, Hadha Kitabu Hamidin. No, this is Hamid's book. And Saeed is saying again, Aina Kitabu Muhammadin, where is Muhammad's book? Yasir is replying that, Huwa Alal Maktabi Hunaka. It is on the desk there. Saeed, Aina Daftaru Ammarin, where is Ammar's register? Yasir is replying here, Huwa Ala Maktabil Mudarrisi. Ala Maktabi is because of harfajar preposition, use maktabi. Al mudarrisi is because of the mudafle. So it is on the teacher's desk. Sa'idu. Kalamu man hadha ya aliyu. Whose pen is this, O Ali? Ali is replying, Aliyu. Hadha kalamul mudarrisi. This pen, this is the teacher's pen. Saeed. Aina. Akhibatul mudarrisi. Where is the mudarris? Where is the teacher's bag? Ali is replying. Here, tahtal maktabi. It is under the table. If you see here, use here because of akhibah. So tamar buddha, it's a female feminine. So use here. Tamarin. Exercises. Ajib anil as'ilatil atiya. Answer to the following questions. Aina kitabu Muhammadin? Where is Muhammad's book? Where is Muhammad's book? Hu alal maktabi hunaka. It is on the table there. It is on the desk there. Aina kitabu Ammarin? Where is Ammar's book? Ammar's book? Huwa ala maktabil mudarrisi. It is on the desk. It is on the teacher's desk. Aina akhibatul mudarrisi. Where is the teacher's bag? Hiya tahta al-maktabi. It is under the table. Inshallah, we'll continue on in the next lesson. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.